G'day all, this is MrPaladin here, and today I'm going to be doing some Ninjaneering offense on Badwater. We're going to start out this round by building a mini sentry while we're inside the spawn door. There is a spot that allows you to build on. You want to pick that up and go get some extra metal from the resupply cabinet so you can dump the mini right as the round starts. And you want to run like heck through the tunnel. The idea is you want to get into their back line so you can build a teleporter exit. You can build extra mini sentries on the run, you've got plenty of mental to do so. Enemies may respawn and exit without taking their teleporters. Most of the time there's no one there, but if they do come out, you're gonna have to deal with them. There's lots of metal back here and health packs. Try and use your pistol with the mini sentry. The enemy will have to target either you or the mini, and they'll often try and take out the mini first. Now that it's clear, we can build our teleporter exit and a dispenser. The dispenser will build on its own and start building up metal while you're doing the rest of this running around. Now you want to get back to your spawn. You can either type kill in console or you can run back there. But it looks like this chaser that had me earlier is starting to get me again, so I'm leading him away from my teleporter. I do not want him to see that. I have some revenge criticals and I want to punch these enemies down. I'm just trying to get back to spawn here. It doesn't matter if I die. I just want to get that teleporter entrance up for my teammates. But while I'm here, I'll dump down some mini sentries and, you know, do my thing. There's a spy, the mini sentry picks him up. Okay, so we're back at the spawn and we're going to build a teleporter entrance for the team. And this is going to allow anyone on your team to get deep into their backline. Now, to show that this can be done frequently, me and another clanmate decided to do this. And both of us are breaking out as engineer with the Revengineer setup. As you see, we both make it down through the tunnel. He's a bit ahead of me. The advantage of two engineers is we're going to be able to have two teleporter exits set up, and by having them split, it's going to be less likely that the enemy's going to be able to take down both. His mini sentry saved me from someone who was trying to chase me down. All we want to do is delay them while we get our stuff set up. He's out ahead of me and he builds his nest up. Then I come through, I see what he's doing, so I decide to build in another place. I build next to this big metal. Okay, let's get back to our spawn. It's okay if we die. We're just gonna harass him back here while we work our way back. It's a good idea to cover this door so that if their teleporters go down, they're gonna be further delayed. You get the idea, let's go back to spawn. We're building up our teleporter entrances. You can usually put both inside the spawn door, but you know, sometimes they clip each other. Keep your eyes open for spies, even though this is an odd place for the teleporters, the spies do still get to them. You want a dispenser at the teleporter exit so you can upgrade the teleporters. Okay, so we got the teleporters up, but why are we doing this? Well, the first thing you want to do is you want to take out the enemy teleporters. We're going to try and spread the enemy over the entire map. Our team can use the teleporters and get out here, get right into their back line, and we can bring the fight to them. And while they're fighting us, I mean, the payload's going to be free to roll, or the payload's going to have little or no resistance. Make the enemy fight over the entire map. There's lots of health and metal here, so you can keep up your mini sentries. You've got revenge criticals going on.
The payload is nearing a checkpoint.
The payload will get to the different control points. And it's totally fun to be doing this. I mean, your teammates come on in, everyone's random, everything's chaotic, the enemy's turning around, doing 360s. Meanwhile, back at the payload, not much is going on. I mean, there's very little resistance. The odd spy, maybe. You know, a little bit of stuff to divert them from the payload. Meanwhile, back at the enemy spawn, there's all sorts of chaos. They're running around like ragdolls, just waiting to have it. Now, as the payload keeps rolling, it's usually unchecked. It all depends on how good your team is, but once it gets to this capture point, your spawn point's gonna have changed. So you're gonna have to make sure that your teleporter entrance changes. You still want to keep the exiters up where it's at, and go on to win the game. You should have plenty of time left. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.
If you've done it, it ain't bragging.